Have you ever had a himbo? Basically, a dude that's really good to look at, means well, just probably missing a couple things up top. 877-995-4681. Y'all can get us on text 99338. Well, we're getting you on hold. We got War of the Roses for you in less than 30 minutes. I got Eddie's email. They've been dating for 7 months. They met online. And he said everything was kind of going right, but he's noticed a lot of guys comment on her Instagram stuff, and she doesn't delete the comments, even though he's not a fan. So, War of the Roses around 8:10 this morning on your morning show. I'm excited to hear about, like, himbos in people's lives. Good morning, Treva.
Hello.
Hey, first of all, thanks for listening in Leesburg, home of Melt and Tally Ho Theater, both fantastic establishments.
I work close to Tally Ho.
Do you?
We love
Tally Ho.
Sorry, I missed your show.
Oh, last year? Well, maybe there'll be another one in a month or so. Who knows, Treva? It's hard to say these days. Also, too, it was a year ago we were in Leesburg that the Taco Bell ran out of meat. Like, legitimately, show. So we got cheese roll-ups. That's another story entirely. Anyway, Treva, we're talking about himbos. Who's the himbo that you know of?
Jared from Siesta Key. He's a total himbo.
Oh, yeah.
Really?
Oh. Yeah. Like, and now that you say it, it's like, yeah, I mean, even, like, his, like, profile photo on Twitter is him feeding a giraffe with his mouth. It's like he means well. Like, he probably shouldn't be left alone with a socket and a fork in case he sees gum on there or something. Do you know what I mean? Like, he means well, though. Treva, thank you so much for calling. Have a great day.
Yes, you too.
Bye. Good morning, Amanda.
Hi.
Oh, my goodness. This is one of my favorite himbos of all time, I think.
Yeah. So, Andy from Parks and Rec, Chris Pratt's character, is a total himbo.
I mean.
Oh, yeah. That makes sense.
Easily, like, top five most lovable.
You guys were describing it, and I was just like, that's immediately him.
I mean, but, though, here's your question, Amanda. Burt Macklin, is he a himbo, or is he a badass mofo?
Well, he seems to know what he's doing.
Right.
So I would say that he's a badass.
Yeah, he found all the Queen's rubies when they were stolen. So, yeah. Burt Macklin, one of the greatest people of all time. Amanda, thank you so much for calling. Have a great day.
You too. Bye-bye.
Bye. If you guys have not seen Chris Pratt as Andy Dwyer on Parks and Rec, truly one of the greatest things in the history of
time. Oh, yeah. It's a must.
Yo, Matt. Matt.
Hey, good morning, guys.
Are we high right now, or what are we doing, bruh?
Possibly, but I just woke up. No, I just wanted to say,
No, Matt, let's pause, Matt. Matt, yeah. Hold on, Matt. Hold on, Zog. Hold on. I can't arrest you. I don't know where you are. You're high right now, right?
Actually, I haven't even left the parking garage. So.
Wow. That does not answer the question.
Good morning.
Yeah, the journey just started.
Oh, man.
Yeah, all right, man. So your day's off to a great start, huh?
Yeah, it's pretty good, actually. It's been nice today. But no, I want to say I kind of
No, Matt, hold on, man. We'll get to that. No, Matt, we'll get to that. We'll get to that, I promise.
Oh, no.
We got time. We're on until 10. So when I pick up the line and I hear this guy laughing to himself, I'm like, this is going to be fantastic. All right.
This is going
to
be great.
So what are we craving, man? We're craving Funyuns. We're craving tacos. What are we craving today?
I don't know. I just made a massive bacon, like, the bacon sandwiches. I make it from home, and I use, like, the Applewood bacon.
Oh, nice.
Oh, yeah, I've heard
of it. Oh, that sounds so good.
Bacon sandwiches.
Yeah, extra cheese. Hey, I told you, I'm in D.C., it's all legal here. So, how I start my morning, it's like my cup of tea or coffee,
Yeah.
All right.
All right. I just like how you tried to say it, though, as if, like, we couldn't tell. Man, I'm getting contact buzz from this conversation, homie.
Can you smell it?
Yeah.
Oh, wait. I can.
All right. Oh, my God.
I love you guys.
Anyway, back to what we're talking about, Matt. So, you heard the himbo, but so you're talking about a bromo?
Well, yes, so I've always been called a bromo. So, like, I don't know. And in the LGBT community, I mean, we're kind of like your friendly neighborhood buddy. Like, always, like, be there for a fun time or a laugh. But I have to be honest, I guess, clearly not often, but a lot of things tend to go over my head, and I'm kind of like this little flighty, loofy.
You are so cute.
Guy.
No, Matt, I don't believe that. I don't believe that for a second, dude. What can possibly get over your head?
Oh, nothing at all. Just a blue sky. But yeah, no, and then I hear, like, himbo, and I think it's kind of the same. It's kind of actually really more accurate. It's like, like a really well put together dude, but yeah. like, you know, is you know, like not pretentious. I think it's very, very direct, actually. I like it.
Okay.
But I think I definitely would have to say I self-identify as a himbo.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
In a hibo, right?
Well, yeah, technically, you know.
All right, Matt.
Oh, my God. You're the best.
Thank you for calling. If you need clean urine, Eric's got you, okay?
Oh, mercy. Thank you guys so much. It's been a blast talking.
See you, dude. Oh, man. That's why we love talking
Good
to you.
Good morning.
Love him.
877-995-4681. What the hell has happened? I don't even know.